Alright, it's a brand new week with a brand new project. Who doesn't like really shiny, glowy objects like this cyborg right here? Well, in this tutorial we're going to explore how we can create this effect by using the shaders that are appropriate to this. For example, the volume shader, it's a principal volume shader that is going to give the light and the ambient a little more touch look. So right now let's start with the basics. If you work your UVs adequately on Blender, you can minimize the polygonal count on your objects. And this is a really important part when you're working with crowd simulations, because this robot is going to be part of a next project that I got for crowd simulation. So I'm really expecting to lower the polygonal count on this. So you can see right here, if you select all the vertices and then you press U and then you press Smart Unwrap, Blender is going to create a projection of your object. And notice how this object is a really complex one, but Blender makes a pretty amazing job at opening it up, and then we can locate it on our UV set. Right here I'm going to show you one of the advantages that you have using the grease pencil tool inside the UV layout. Right now I'm drawing the space that I'm going to be working with the UV sets right there on the viewport. I have not ever used this kind of feature before on any other software, and I've been using a lot of softwares, but it came to me that the grease pencil tool may actually deliver this kind of intuitive workflow to organize your UV sets. Now, originally what we would like to do is to work with UDIM UV sets, which will allow for much more definition on the textures. But right now, my main idea here is to demonstrate that you can create many UV sets inside the same texture using Smart UV Unwrap. Most people will not agree that this is a convenient method to do things, because it will arbitrarily display and relax all the UV sets. But for us right now, I don't think it's going to be a problem, because this is just a quick solution to know where the UV space should go. And since this is going to be only a 1K texture, I'm not going to work with big textures, although if we would, we would also get a lot of good resolutions. Right now, you're not seeing any of the other UV sets, because you need to check from the UV editor the option that says that you would like to view the other UV sets whenever they are selected. I am selecting them right here, and then they appear over here. So this is a selection that you get from the view menu down here in the UV editor. Then you mark that you would like to see the others, the other UV sets. By default, it will not do it. But if you do it this way, and you probably may not see that much clear, you can go here to the user preferences and then go into the UV image editor. And from there on, you can move the colors for the other UV sets. In this case, I'm going to select a yellow color, because I think it's very much defined over black and dark areas. So I'm going to leave it like that and save my user settings. All right, so we have everything in place, and now I'm going to show you a nifty little trick. If you select parts of your mesh to recreate them or to diminish the polygonal count, you're going to see that change reflected on your UV set. Now, this is really amazing, but the one thing you're going to take notice that you're going to need to fix is that later, all the deleted or fused faces are going to be strangling around each other, like you can see right here on the UV space. And also, if you're dissolving faces, you should also take care of the single vertex points that are floating there. By pressing X and then the letter D, then you can delete those single vertices. So I'm going to show you another little trick that I got. Whenever I export something to Substance Painter, I do create a additional Blender file to have all my objects as individual objects, and then another one Blender file to have all my objects as a one single object, just like you saw that little black droid there. And I'm going to show you also that if you make this setup, you can bake normals from a high definition model versus a low polygonal model. So this is a result of a bad normal work. I mean, normals are pretty messed up there, but you can do that also as well in Blender. Right now I'm switching to Substance Painter, and from here on we need to go to texture settings, and then the first thing is to bake the mesh maps. This will automatically create maps where Substance Painter will work accordingly with all the channels that it has for smart materials or textures or other brushes. So it's baking all the maps, all the necessary maps, so for the materials to work as well. And now we switch back into layers. But first, let's open up the window for the 2D and 3D view. And you can rotate the view by pressing Alt and then using the left mouse button, you can rotate there. Now I'm switching to the shelf and dragging and dropping directly onto the layers or onto the object. In this case, I'm going to drop it into the object and I get a quick result now that I have my maps baked, and it's pretty amazing. I really like this. Now I'm going to use masks so I can paint, and then I will reveal my material throughout this mask. So right now I'm just doing this very quickly. This is not a Substance Painter tutorial, but rather what is the correct workflow to export an emission texture to Blender. So right here, I'm almost done with my material. I really like the look of this. And then I'm going to suggest to you that whatever you do, obviously, you're going to save it. And this is a work after some 45 minutes or so. I'm going to define my set, what the name of the shader is going to be. So in this case, I'm going to call this E-Droid. Just like so, E-Droid, that's the general name. So right now I'm going to test the first export, and then I'm going to choose the location, selecting the folder. Obviously, I'm going to select Blender Cycles preset. You can see it right there on configuration. Blender Cycles preset, and then it exports. Now let's see all the texture that has exported for the first time. This is just a quick test, and I want to see and set up the PBR material inside Blender. Now to do that, you select the principal BSDF shader, press Ctrl T, and then this automatically will take you into the import the PBR texture material. See, principal materials shading, and the network is automatically created. This is just marvelous. This will save you a lot of times the hassle and the troubles to set your textures correctly. Now you can see the texture is almost washed out. I don't really care right now because it has to do with settings on color corrections or curves. I don't care about that. Now we're going to go for the real thing. I'm presenting you again my workflow. This time it was around some 2 hours or so. I'm pretty much accelerating time here, and I'm defining this E-Droid to have the correct colors for the emission. You can see right there on the arrow, I've created a dedicated layer to paint where I want the emission to happen. By default, you can also create many other variations on your brushes with alphas. You can use alphas to do that. And finally, I'm going to press this button, the Photoshop button, and then I'm going to tell Substance Painter to just export the base color. And when I do that, I'm sorry, I just pushed cancel and I just launch. Well, you should press OK. So now you're seeing all the correct import. Please save this file because we're going to need this for later on our emission map. And what we want to create is just a clean black texture with the overlays of the emission. In this case, I'm going isolating my elements. And then I want to try to export two different materials, one for the blue emissions and then one for the red emissions. So I'm going to select export textures. Once again, I'm going to switch to my Blender Cycles preset. It comes by default on Subsystems Painter. And then I'm going to select the location. By selecting the location there, I'm ready to export. And then I click export. Oh, I'm sorry, I just canceled because I wanted to correctly identify my textures. This is called Edroid Red. So all these textures are going to be labeled the same way, Edroid Red, plus the diffuse channel. In this case, normal channel, height, glossiness, or spec, or roughness. So that's the name I would like. And the name is given onto the texture set settings. So now I export that, and then I get my texture. So I'm going to go back and then rename this Edroid Blue, because right now I'm going to export all the blue textures for the same robot. So layers, I'm going to go to the I'm going to switch this on, switch this off, switch this on, and switch this right here off. There you go. Now we have a brand new robot. I'm going to export this, and since I already switched the name is already given right there, Edroid Blue. So now I'm selecting again all my settings and then exporting. So now I have two texture sets, one for the red robot and then one for the blue robot. And of course, you should save your progress on Systems Painter. Back on Blender, just like I told you, select your PBR textures by Ctrl T, and then select in any order your textures. They will be automatically feed onto the principal BSD shader. Now let's take a look. I'm going to go back. I did open this file from the individual pieces that I had on this robot. I'm not opening the same one piece robot. No, I'm opening this file on the different pieces I got. Why? Because right now it's time to feed the different emission textures that I have. So this is the idea here. The previous PSD file that you exported needs to have this background, this black background, so that it won't emit, and then the color emissions on the colors you would like to be emitting from. And in this case, I'm going to name this blue and red emission texture. See? Blue, red. And now I'm going to connect the mapping section from the nodes onto the image texture, and I'm going to feed the image emission texture into an emission node. You can see it right here. Right now, I'm testing this with a mix shader. That's why you can see it right there. But later on, we will switch this onto a add shader node. So please take that in notice. All right, looking pretty good, pretty amazing. Really like this. Look at that. Strength 50, and I'm getting really nice results. Let's create a plane. Quickly, let's assign on a material, a dark material, by the way, and then let's create a cube so we can create a new volume. In this case, we adapt it onto the surface where we want, and now we are going to switch the drawing mode into wire. We're going to assign a new material, principal volume shader, and then we were supposed to connect it into the volume, and I really forgot, I apologize for that, but right now if you plug it into the surface, we're going to get some results as well. And I also switched my light, I created a new light and switched it into a spotlight, because we really need a concentrated light with a lot of power. So in this case I'm going to use the emissions from the texture on the robot as 50. Well, this is looking pretty amazing. Now if you select your light, select show your cone, and then you're going to get a notion to where the light is going through. Now I'm finally adding the add shader before the end of the material. This is important because this is going to work with our passes. This is important, so keep that in mind. Alright, this is our preview looking pretty good. Now we're finally going to do the emission pass. Now how do we do that? Well, I'm testing right here the first frame. You can see the different passes, and over to the right side you can check all the passes are marked down like see, mist, normal, UV, shadow. But this odd shader plus this emission plus this texture are the ones who are really making the magic happening. If you can see, this is the PSD file that we previously saved. And now just mark this little dot right here, emission, this little checkbox right here on emission, and then let's try it out with the red emission texture. Let's see what's happening. Wow, really, really nice. So that's what we're looking for, that emission pass all the way and render directly from the texture. Looking great. This shadow and other passes may lead you to create your own composite image like this one. So remember all these little tips, and I'll see you on the next video. Thank you very much.